rods on top of the reactors. I mean, that's another example of just these people just always doing it in the most flimsy way they can. And it just shows an overall breakdown of common sense and no long-term view by the global ruling elite. I mean, they're just a bunch of nutcases.
Well, I agree with that. Yeah, I think that, and a bunch of liars. Everything they say is a lie. And I certainly agree with that. We have nutcases ruling, and they lie. Look, you know what you ought to do? You ought to find somebody to tell you what are the temperatures inside those nuclear reactors. Because the point that struck me, I don't know anything about it, but you would think a nuclear fire is a higher temperature than a kerosene fire. And these nuclear reactors have been melting down now for over a week. And why isn't all the steel containment, which is not very thick, nothing like the steel beams in the World Trade Center towers, why is it melted?
Yes, sir.
How did the kerosene fire cause massive steel structures to collapse in an hour? You know, limited, low temperature fires, not even throughout the building. And yet we can have these meltdowns. I don't know what temperatures are involved in meltdowns.
We know 754 degrees to about 1,200. And some reports now that the total meltdown happened in as high as 3,000 degrees.
A centigrade or Fahrenheit?
Fahrenheit.
Well, if you've got 1,200 degrees Fahrenheit or 3,000, you're so far beyond anything any kerosene fire can produce. And yet, the steel containment around these reactors is not melted yet. Or if it has, it's just...
Well, no, actually, after 2 weeks at number two, it finally did melt
right,
through...
2 weeks.
Two weeks.
All right. Well, compare those 2 weeks, those high temperatures...
Actually, sir, to be technical, it didn't melt. Two, when it blew up, blew a hole in it, and it ran out. I'm sorry, I have the Associated Press right here.
Okay. Well, anyhow, somebody really ought to look at that, because...
No, you're right. It never melted even with thousands of degrees. I mean, to be technical, a hole was blown from the outside in one of the explosions, and it was breached, and then it melted inside and ran out. But no, it did not go through the steel.
Well, somebody needs, I don't know, but somebody that does know should face the question why nuclear fires didn't melt steel, but kerosene fires did, and why nuclear fires didn't melt it after all of these days and days. But it only took an hour in one of the World Trade Center buildings and an hour and a half in the other for a limited, smothered kerosene fire to...
Well, Doctor, we have the firefighters on video and the video of it saying it was molten lava just
right.
Pouring and bubbling. I mean, how does kerosene do that?
Right, it can't. But you see, we might be able to make people... If the temperatures in those nuclear reactors are really as high as you said, we know what the maximum temperatures are in the kerosene fire, and we can just simply say, isn't this amazing that much thinner steel held up for weeks under much higher temperatures in one place, and it just completely collapsed in the other. Now, I guess NIST will come back and say, oh, well, Japanese make better steel than Americans. Maybe that's the answer.
Actually, some of that steel was Japanese.
The Japanese have fireproof steel.
Well, yeah, you can now burn a building down. They're talking about changing big building codes now, saying that a lighter can burn one down, and the engineers are fighting them on it, so they're having some trouble. In closing, Dr. Roberts, looking at this hypocrisy, what do you think of the fact that the Congress wasn't even consulted, no resolution, no authorization of force, and that only Ron Paul, Dennis Kucinich, and a few others, it's like six members have complained. All the rest say, we want to be vestigial, we want to be ceremonial. When the UN gives an order to Lord Obama, he follows it. I mean, this means the end of any checks and balances.
Well, Obama took Bush one step further. He didn't even ask for congressional authorization. He just acted on his own. So I call this the final step into Caesarism. We now have a Caesar. He can do what he wants. The law is meaningless. It has no effect. He's not subject to law. Unless maybe he has an affair with an intern. situation we're in. U.S. government, executive branch, only the executive branch. Of course, Congress can be penalized in the judiciary, but the executive branch is now above the law. It doesn't have to follow the law. Look how it's treating Bradley Manning. That's illegal. It's not even a protest. You'd think the ACLU would have all kinds of court cases about the torture of Bradley Manning. But, so we, you know, what is it? I don't see how it's any different than the Gestapo or Stalin.
Well, that's my next issue. I think we need to take things back at the state level, continue to expose this tyranny as our last ditch to try to stop this ahead of the 1776 option. But talking to you, I mean, I kind of get sometimes that you think the only option could be 1776.
I don't really know if we have an option because the people are so ignorant. They're so brainwashed because of patriotism. And they have no preparation, and it's going to come on them suddenly.
I tell you what, Doc, we're going into overdrive. Do 5 more minutes with us if you can, and we're going to take some calls.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Alex has told you about the terrible perfect storm of rising food prices. The Japanese tragedy proves how important food is. Our own gas prices are driving food costs through the roof. The huge population countries are buying up American unprotected exports of food. The falling dollar is inflating food prices. Ethanol subsidies are driving fuel and food costs to all-time highs. We are experiencing the greatest explosion of food shortages and food prices America has ever seen. Folks, you have to freeze the cost and availability of your food now. Through March 31st, eFoods Direct has free shipping on all orders. You can freeze the cost and availability of your food and have it shipped free. Call 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Free shipping ends March 31st. 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. We now take you live
to the Central Texas Command Center
in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to the Alex Jones Show.
I have promised to go to George Perry, Robert Jasper, and others. We're live into overdrive, deeper into the hour. We're going to let Dr. Roberts go here in about 5 minutes. Former head of policy, Reagan administration at the Treasury, written many books. His latest book, How the Economy Was Lost, The War of the Worlds, tells why America is disintegrating. And it's available just better bookstores everywhere, Amazon.com as well. He also writes public columns and just gives them out to everybody. Great guy. Used to write syndicated columns but didn't like being censored. So he just fights for absolutely free, the true mark of a true patriot. And we really appreciate he's fighting for freedom, which is the greatest prize, the great jewel. In closing, we were talking during that one-minute break, Dr. Roberts, and I was saying, I wish there was a free country to move to. You were saying, yeah, there really is nowhere with these globalists. They're trying to destroy Switzerland. You pointed out that's one of the better places still, but they're trying to get rid of its laws and its sovereignty. And then you said, but I don't think that they can get China. Elaborate on that.
Well, it has a government that has long-term thought capability and that is in control of the situation, has planned to make China the world power, and that realizes the United States is insane and will be doing whatever it can to insulate itself from the fallout of the American collapse. So I don't think China has any interest in globalism. You know, China has always been Chinese.
Isolationist.
That's right. They're Chinese, and they're not globalists. And so I don't think any kind of scheme can get them, but I could be wrong.
Well, listen, Mao had to kill 60-something million of them to get them in line. They are the original capitalist. And what you're saying is that communism is about a centimeter thick. Under it is basically isolationist business people, and China, and that won't play too well. Look how China spends all their money getting 94% of rare earth mineral mines in the world. Look right. at how they're building highways, speed rail, everything. We have got a dilapidated 70-year-old rail beds in this country.
Yeah, you can hardly go anywhere on a train here. I think China is outside of their plans, and I think Russia is too. I don't think they can get Russia. They're trying, but I don't think they can. And they almost did, but Putin put an end to that. And I just don't believe that they have the kind of power to do what this globalism thing is all about. I just don't think they have power.
But they sure run our country, and they're sure going to rob us on the way to destruction and attack every country they can.
Well, they seem to be doing that. You know, look, we were talking about what the American people can do, and the trouble with the people is, I was saying, they're brainwashed because of their patriotism, they're ignorant, they're unaware, and so they haven't any reserves. I mean, people don't have food stocks, they don't have any plans, they don't have any unity. You know, people don't like each other, neighbors can't get along, people are more, they're more concerned to run down the people they need to be united with.
Well, you're right. On average, America is lazy and rotten. That doesn't mean we don't have good people here, but I got to tell you, Americans have become lazy and rotten.
Yeah, and they have no awareness. There's no unity. And they're so split and divided, and they're at each other's throats. I'm not just talking about rich and poor. I'm talking about among the poor, among the middle class. You know, it's not a... I don't think the United States, is, for a very long time, has ever had any real unity. It's every person for himself, you know. It's even broken up families. It's like that, even with families.
Yeah.
And so that doesn't give you any possibility of a 1776.
Well, it's a cycle of decadence, though. Every society goes through this, and in the end, it is what it is. We've got to spread the word and do what we can. There is an awakening happening, but you're right. A lot of folks are very decadent. Dr. Roberts, thank you for spending time with us. We look forward to speaking to you again there very soon.
Okay, Alex. Thank you very much.
Thank Goodbye. You. Thank you, sir. Have a great week coming up. We're going to come back, take your phone calls, cover some other issues. Stay with us. Key information straight ahead.
David J. Smith for Newswatch Magazine. Did you know that the United Nations is a Trojan horse and that the Secretary General of the United Nations has always been a socialist from the day that it was founded? Therefore, it can only bring about a one-world communist government. Do you realize that they will be in charge of all weaponry if the United States and every other nation turns over to it? Any nation that rebels, they will just send a nuclear weapon to bring it into subjection. We'd like to help you understand how these world events are going to affect you in the near future by offering you a one-year free subscription to Newswatch Magazine. Just call our toll-free number, 1-800-516-8736. That's 1-800-516-8736. Call now while operators are standing by.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty, and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches, and the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like no...